after what has transpired at the Forum for Democratic Change in the last few days. The people in the northern city see the infights within the opposition party as the beginning of its collapse.
The FDC is not a good party because I saw there's a lot of problem in FDC. Yeah, because sometimes they disorganize people.
The highly publicized fights between the top party leaders Nandala Mafabi and Ssemujju Nganda is seen as toxic and not good for opposition politics.
Like FDC, which they are supposed to be a armor to pull the government from the power, are being so disturbed by two or three people. I am so scared, and I am not happy for the things that are happening up there. I don't know whether they're grabbing money from the government or maybe they need something from the government.
Okello David is a businessman. He believes that it is time for the country to move on from chaotic politics.
Now, as I talk, I see like FDC is not strong as usually to be those previous times. Moreover, they call them FDC, Forum for Democratic Change. But I think the government is forcing the armor to pull some nails from the FDC hands. But that is not the way they should handle their problems. They should sit down with their board members or committee members or a caucus so that they solve the problem that they have.
The comments made by this gentleman come at a time when the FDC leadership is being criticized for unleashing unwarranted violence on journalists at their party headquarters in Najanakumbi. Francis Otim, who subscribes to the Democratic Party and represents the people of Kirombe Ward in Gulu City Council, wants the FDC to come out publicly to work with the ruling NRM party as Norbert Mao did.
You have two headquarters, one at Najanakumbi and one at the other location within the city. So what is happening in FDC is a prophecy of Norbert Mao's statements that in opposition there is a lot of hypocrisy. There are people who visit the president at night and pretend that they are clean.
The FDC party grassroots elections have been halted due to the ongoing fights. The General Secretary for Acholi Subregion, Oyat Wilson Chaga, reveals that the process was scheduled to start in June 2023. But money was never released by the party.
It has caused a lot. The resources that we have to use in the grassroots elections are not available because of the situation at the headquarters. Otherwise, all the supervisors, right from the ward and parishes, sub-counties, and at the district level, were all selected, await training.
It is in the current disorganization being exhibited by the FDC in the opposition politics that Francis Otim believes that a coalition with the ruling party will save the country from dirty politics.
I believe that for us to have good politics in the country, we don't need very many political parties. And if we need, and if there are many political parties, and then I think a coalition can work for us to press the government. But what is happening right now, everyone is going to get their share. To me, my advice to the FDC would be, they should be bold, like the Democratic Party. They should go and sign a cooperation agreement with the ruling government.
However, the FDC structures in Gulu City still have hope that they can reunite and form a formidable force ahead of the 2026 general elections.
I would not side with any of these parties because I'm an FDC and I support FDC. My target is to ensure FDC prevails over all of them so that we make things move.
The Forum for Democratic Change, commonly known as the FDC, is an opposition party that was formed on the 16th of December 2004 with the main aim of wrestling power from the strong grip of the ruling NRM party. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.